Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is April and you're welcome back to my YouTube channel if you're a returning viewer. And if you're a new viewer, then of course you are welcome to my channel. If you like the kind of content that you see on my channel page, then of course subscribe to my channel and don't forget to click on the bell notification button to always be notified whenever I post a new video. As you guys can see from the title of today's video, we are going a bit professional. Today we are going to be talking about CVs. So basically I'm going to be telling you guys what a CV is, how to go about writing a CV, the kind of information to include, what not to include, and I'm also going to be giving you a few tips on writing a CV. Now I would like to put out a disclaimer that I am not an expert in careers and counseling or anything like that, absolutely not. But I did do a previous video on internships, on how to get an internship, and a number of you guys asked me to make a video on CVs because I have written quite a number of CVs in my life, and my CV has definitely helped me in getting some of the job opportunities that I have had over the years. And not even just job opportunities, but other opportunities like the opportunity to participate in various programs and projects and other things of this nature. So I do have some experience in CV writing, and I'm just going to share with you guys my perspective on CV writing today, so stay tuned. So first and foremost, what is a CV? Basically, a CV is just a document that contains information about you, primarily academic and professional information. But also your CV is meant to cover other aspects of your life, such as your interests, your skills, things of this nature. So basically your CV is sort of like an introduction to yourself. So we use CVs when we are applying for jobs, internships, if you want to further your education, so you're applying for a master's degree, you need a CV. Or also for various programs, you know, study abroad and other programs of this nature, you would need a CV. So I think without doubt, you can say that a CV is definitely one of the most important documents that every adult should have and should perfect, in my opinion. So the very first tip that I would like to give about CVs is that it has to be clear, it has to be concise, and it has to be straight to the point. We are not going around the bush talking about unnecessary things. We are going straight to what is important and also to what is relevant. So basically, just include what is relevant to whatever it is that you are applying for. So experiences that would boost your application, rather than create a bad impression of you or things which are just irrelevant. And also always pay attention to the length of your CV. The standard length of a CV should be 1 to 2 pages, but then certain opportunities which require you to apply using a CV will have a specific number of pages or even words that they would require you to limit your CV up to. So you have to pay attention. If the application says your CV has to be only 1 page, then if the CV that you have is 5 pages, you have to edit it to fit 1 page. You don't just send a 5-page CV when the job opportunity or the program opportunity requires you to apply with a 1-page CV. So that's what I mean by tailoring your CV to whatever opportunity it is that you're applying for. Now, to the contents of your CV, every CV has to include your education. So that is where you went to university primarily, although some people do also include where they went to high school. It must also include your professional work experience. So internships, part-time jobs, full-time jobs, national service experiences. Then your CV must also include your skills. So if you have, you know, good interpersonal skills, you have good communication skills, you have good writing skills, your CV must include that. It must also include your interests and your hobbies and your awards, if you have ever received any awards or if you have ever participated in any competitions. It should also include leadership positions and projects that you participated in, if there are any. And it should also include the languages that you're proficient in. That's the basic information that has to be on a CV. And then, of course, it can be very dependent on the person. Some people haven't been in leadership positions. Other people haven't really participated in lots of extracurricular activities. And there are some people who haven't won any significant award. So the CV has to be tailored to you, depending on your background and your experiences. That is very, very important. It is also important to note that you shouldn't start your CV from your kindergarten days to your primary days to your high school days, all your experiences starting from when you turned 5 years old. All of that is not relevant because a CV is primarily used for professional purposes in our adult lives. So the experiences that are usually relevant are those that start from maybe high school, that's senior high school, upward. So university is crucial, and any professional experiences that you've had as a young adult, Let's say starting from 17, 18 years, that is the most important information. Of course, if you were a child star and you are applying for a media role or a media position somewhere, then it is important to include the fact that you were a celebrity at a young age, or you did participate in commercials, or you were an actor from a very young age. So again, this varies from person to person. What you need to also know is that depending on the position that you're applying for, you will have to tailor the look of your CV. So if you're applying for a creative position, you can tailor your CV to make it a bit more creative. Maybe you can use a template, a Microsoft Word template, to make it more colorful, or you can go online and find a template online to make your CV look colorful, you know, interesting to read. But if you are applying for a more strict, rigid kind of position, let's say in finance or in law, then of course it is better to keep your CV simple, straight to the point. And also, it is important to never attach your photo to your CV, at least in Commonwealth countries like Ghana. In most English-speaking countries, it is seen as very unprofessional to attach your picture to a CV. The potential employer or the person who is going to review your CV is not meant to know what you look like. Usually they'll get to know what you look like when you come for the interview. So yes, the main purpose of a CV is for you to progress to the interview stage. Most times, it's not all the time that there is an interview in an application process, whether it's for studies or it's for a job, but a lot of the time the CV is the stage that comes before the interview. So on the basis of your CV and sometimes other documents as well, like essays that you are meant to write and other questions that you are meant to answer, they would decide whether or not they want you to come for an interview. So that is when the committee that is assessing you will actually get to see you. They don't need to see your face on the CV. So I have a sample CV which I came up with myself just for the purpose of this video, and of course it's not perfect, but it does show, just generally speaking, what a standard plain CV looks like. So again, you'll have to tailor it based on yourself, based on the position that you're applying for, and of course to some extent based on your personality. So this is a sample CV of a fictional lady who doesn't exist. Her name is Ajua Mensah, as you guys can see. So of course, the name of the person has to be in bold. It has to be clear who is applying for whatever it is, position, right? Or whatever opportunity it is. And then we have the address. That's Ajua's address, Ajua's contact number, and Ajua's email address. And this is a PO box address. If you would prefer to put your home address there, you can do so as well. Then we have something we call a personal statement, which is just a short description of the person whose CV it is. So I personally am not a big fan of personal statements, but many people do include them, and they do tailor them, again, depending on the position that they are applying for. So in this case, for example, Ajua makes it clear that she's a quick learner with an exceptionally strong work ethic. So basically, your personal statement makes it clear who you are as a person, and it just basically highlights your good qualities, right? That would make you a good candidate for whatever position it is that you're applying for. Next, we have the very important part of education and certification. It is also important to note that with your CV, whether it's under education or work experience or projects and leadership positions, you have to mention the most current activity or educational qualification that you have first. So with this example, Ajua is currently at the University of Ghana. I made a mistake. I wrote School of Law. No, Ajua is at the University of Ghana. So that is the very first thing that she mentions on her CV. She makes it clear that she's currently at the University of Ghana from September 2018 to present, and she's studying economics. That's a BA, Bachelor of Arts in Economics. And she went to Wesley Girls Senior High School. That was earlier. So her earlier education comes after her current education. That's the sequence that should be followed. Then we have the work experience. So again, she's currently working as an intern at Ecobank, and that's the first work experience that she places here. She's been working there from September 2020 till present. This is, of course, because of the closure of university. So she's currently not in school, she's interning. And of course, when you are talking about your work experience, it is important to highlight what exactly you do at your job. And it is important to go quite into detail when it comes to your job description. or your previous job description. So in this case, for example, Ajua handles professional analytical and management support work assignments. She prepares weekly financial reports at Ecobank. She develops and utilizes spreadsheets, databases, and other computer applications, etc., etc. And before, that was last year, she was also an intern at Wells Fargo Advisors. So it is important to note that she is an economics major. So her CV is mostly showing her experience in finance and in economics, things related to that. And even though I didn't read it, in her personal statement, she made it clear that she wants to be a banker in the future. So that is also important. So when it comes to her internship experience at Wells Fargo Advisors, she made it clear that she expanded knowledge base by participating in training, seminars, conference calls. She also did a number of researches. She wrote about hedge funds, reinsurance. So basically, she explained what she did as an intern at Wells Fargo. Then when it comes to projects and leadership positions, here we can see that Ajua is not very strong. She is currently a financial secretary of her church. So she's been the financial secretary of her church since 2019. And she was also a prefect in high school. And she also participated in LifeLink's tertiary model United Nations. When it comes to awards, she has only had one award. And then when it comes to skills, she has noted the skills that she has: strong communication, active listening, interpersonal skills. She's advanced in Microsoft Word and Microsoft Excel. Very important skill sets, especially problem-solving skills and her expertise in numbers and math skills. Very important considering the fact that, again, she's into economics, she's into finance. You know, she'll have to be working a lot with numbers, with predictions, problem-solving and things like that. Then when it comes to languages and her interests, she makes it clear as well that her native language is English and she also speaks Ga. Then she's intermediate in Chui and her French is basic. And then when it comes to her interests, she has noted socializing, listening to podcasts, reading, watching documentaries, traveling. When it comes to references, now there is a trend on making references available on request. A reference is a person who can vouch for you, vouch for your skill set, vouch for your professional and academic experiences. For students, usually references are lecturers, right, or academic advisors, people who are close to them. It is not advisable to put a family member as a reference or a pastor. These people tend to be generally biased, so that is not recommended. Generally speaking, it is best to put, let's say, a previous employer or your lecturer or your academic advisor as your reference. So when it comes to references, if you do choose to put a reference, usually it's two references that are put, if they are put at all, then you have to include their full name, their position, their email address, their contact number. That's usually the information that is required. But making references available on request is also an option, meaning that the potential employer or the person who is reviewing your CV will specifically contact you for a reference or for two references if it's necessary. And also, I'd like to note that Ajua doesn't have any volunteering experience or anything of that sort. But if you do have that, if you are active in church, for example, you have volunteered at a hospital or at an orphanage, all of these things are relevant to your CV, depending again on the position that you're applying for. So maybe in this case, fictional Ajua Mensa tailored her CV specifically for a very particular position that she was applying for. So maybe she didn't include other experiences that she's had. The very last thing that I would like to say about CVs is that you should never, and I mean never, lie on your CV. If you say you have basic knowledge of French, make sure that your French is basic and not non-existent, please. The reason I'm saying this is because a lot of people put things in their CV which they either don't understand or which is not true. So when you go for an interview and you are questioned on what you've written in your CV and you can't reply or you can't reply appropriately, trust me, you are never going to get whatever opportunity it is that you applied for, because it will be obvious that you lied or you exaggerated something. There are people who use words that they don't know in CVs. So, for example, they don't know what interpersonal skills are. They include great interpersonal skills. Then when they go for an interview and then they are questioned on that, they don't really know what to say because they don't even know what it is. So what I'm trying to say is that whether it is a language, a hobby, or a skill set that you include in your CV, make sure that it is true. Make sure that if you write that, oh, you listen to podcasts, when you go for an interview and then you are asked, oh, what kind of podcasts do you listen to? You know, tell us a bit about them. you should be able to mention at least one or two podcasts and go into details about what is talked about in this podcast. So, of course, I hope that this video has helped you. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate to drop them in the comment section. I always reply to comments. So definitely do that and I'll reply to your comments. And of course, if you also don't agree with certain things that I stated in this video, you can also give your perspective in the comment section below. And any other advice or tips that you guys have, which I was not able to mention in this video, they are also appreciated in the comment section. But besides that, we've come to the end of this video and I hope to see you guys next time. Bye!